thanks you all for shaking. This feel like a prison, and I can do what I do. If you kinda choose to watch this, I feel like I'm dying, but it's you who revive me. So I will do my best to keep my dream goes on. And so today, I borrow an interface from my friends. This one sounds so good that you can't imagine. Please, don't let the price point fool you, because it is me that gonna make you see through. What's up YouTube? Today I'm gonna talk about this interface, Behringer UMC204HD. And you're probably wondering why I also mentioned 202HD on this video. Because these tools are pretty similar in terms of sound quality and build quality. I will discuss later on this video what is different between these two. So let's not waste any time, let's get into the detail.
First of all, we talk about the build quality. It has metal construct and it feels strong. Overall, the body of this interface is solid and have weight into it. Now let's talk about what we got on this interface. There is two combo jack input on the front of the interface, and under the input there are a little text say Midas preamp. We will talk about that later in this video. And next to it, there is two gain knobs to control volume each of these inputs. And they also have line instrument switch for switching between line level and instrument level. And there is a pass switch for you if you are going to record something with high attack. They also have signal indicator to see if interface receive any signal coming from inputs, and clip indicator to see if what you're recording is clipping. There is a stereo and mono switch for direct monitoring, so you can choose to hear what you record in stereo or mono. They also have MIDI in and out indicator to see if MIDI signal is sent and received correctly. Next to it is monitor mix knob, which is really essential right now in audio interface these days. This knob will let you blend between the sound that comes from your computer playback or the signal that comes from your input, which is useful if you are tracking vocals. Under of it, there is a main output knob to control volume of your studio monitor. There is a monitor AB button that let you switch between output A and output B on the back of the interface. There is a power indicator to see if interface is connected to a computer. There is a 48V indicator to see if phantom power is turned on or off. Next to it is headphone volume knob to control volume of your headphone. Lastly, on the front is 6.3mm headphone output for connecting your headphone. Move on to the back of the interface, you can clearly see USB port for connecting to your computer. Next to it is a MIDI I/O port for connecting external MIDI device. Next, there is a 48V phantom power switch. Above that, there is a Kensington lock if you're going to use it in a public place for educational or whatever. Next, there is a pair of RCA outputs. This can use to connect with any DJ mixer. Next, there is a 1/4-inch jack output for connecting your studio monitor. And lastly, is a good things of this interface, a pair of inserts, which is allow you to insert any external effect device like compressor, delay, reverb, or EQ. You can even use it to connect to external preamp, because this insert is already bypassed the preamp on this interface, which is great. Now let's talk about tech and specs. This interface have 51 dB of gain range. It has bit depth of 24 bit and 192 kHz of sampling rate. It have 110 dB of dynamic range. And remember what I say about Midas preamp? The noise on this preamp is so low. Equivalent input noise on this interface is -129 dB, which is really great compared to other interface in this price range. And this information is referenced from one of the YouTube channel, Julian Krause. He is great. You can go check him out if you haven't. Now I'm gonna talk about difference between 204 and 202 HD. In 204 HD, you have a lot more option and expandability. It feels a lot more flexible because 202 HD is lack of monitor mix knob. This is really important features nowadays. It don't have RCA output, so you can't use any DJ mixer with it if you want to. It also lack of MIDI I/O for who want to use external MIDI gear. And lastly, it can't insert any effect, so it's your choice to choose what you really need because these two are sounds great and built like a tank. Now let's hear how it sounds in singing. This is a test from Behringer UMC 204 HD. Whoa, this preamp sounds so clean. There is no reason that you shouldn't buy Behringer. This is a test from Behringer UMC 204 HD. Whoa, this preamp sounds so clean. There is no reason that you shouldn't buy Behringer. The sound is so good for the price, and I'm sure it will make you surprised, Behringer. Thanks you all for checking. This feel like a present, and I can do what I do. If you kinda choose to watch this, I feel like I'm dying, but it's you who revive me. So I will do my best to keep my dream goes on. And so today, I borrow an interface from my friends. This one sounds so good than you can imagine. Please, don't let the price point fool you, because it is me that gonna make you see it through. Thanks you all for checking. This feel like a present, and I can do what I do. If you kinda choose to watch this, I feel like I'm dying, but it's you who revive me. So I will do my best to keep my dream goes on. And so today, I borrow an interface from my friends. This one sounds so good that you can't imagine. Please, don't let the price point fool you, because it is me that gonna make you see through. This interface also gives you a lot of instrument and effect plugin. You can download it from Behringer website, and you can also claim Waveform OEM, which is a DAW for free. This software can give you what you need for your work out of the box.
Okay, into conclusion, I would say that this interface is surprisingly good for the price. The preamp is sound so clean and built like a tank. So by the way, this interface is really worth the money you're spending. And that's it for today, guys. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you continue to support me in the future, I can show you a lot more gears to review in the future video. So have a nice day. Peace out.
Thanks you all for checking. This feel like a present, and I can do what I do. If you kinda choose to watch this, I feel like I'm dying, but it's you who revive me. So I will do my best to keep my dream goes on. And so today, I borrow an interface from my friends. This one sounds so good that you